Welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk about how to choose the right art fair for your art business. If you are a self-managing artist or professional art dealer, you're trying to show some art in one of the upcoming art fairs and you're not sure which one. Guess what? You are not alone. There are many art professionals out there are still not sure because everything is changing all the time. The numbers of art fairs have been growing exponentially over the past decade. There's so many new fairs out there that I have not even heard of, and that's why it's important to do your research following this method. I'll be showing you 7 questions that you need to ask yourself before choosing the art fair so that you can make the most out of paying for those fairs and you can sell art and have a successful business. Without further ado, let's get into it. The first thing you need to ask yourself is this niche right for my gallery? When I say niche, I don't mean that you should go to only the niche fairs, but personally speaking, I think the niche fairs are the future of art fairs. There are some more broad art fairs like the successful established ones that are famous around the world, like the Art Basel, like the FIAC, like the ARCO. They're the best in their country or their region. However, those fairs are super selective and you need really to be within their radar to be invited, otherwise there's no way that you can work around, you can get into. It's not possible. Therefore, your choices are among those copycats or those niche art fairs. Personally, I think the niche fairs are a better deal for you as a new gallery than the copycats. The copycats are basically satellite events that are very similar to those main events without much of a focus. For example, I would say Art Madrid and Just Madrid are the copycats of ARCO. I don't say it in a bad way. Personally, I think the smaller niche fairs are a lot better, such as the Hotel Art Fair Hybrid, the drawing room for the works on paper, such as the Urvanity for the street art, and there are many art fairs like that for photography, for new media art, for every kind of art, for every style and price, there is a niche art fair. And I think it's good to go to the niche art fair so you can meet the right collectors for your art and you can really make the artworks shine and find the right link in the context, instead of trying to go to one of the more generic contemporary art fairs, they call it the emerging or the affordable art fairs, that I think there's nothing wrong with them, but their lack of a certain kind of focus that can be a waste of your time if your artists are very niche. However, the niche art fairs are double-bladed. There are also some downside. I was talking to a gallerist who are representing a very famous street artist in Art Madrid, and I was asking him, why didn't you go to Urvanity, which is a street art fair, and that's gonna be a lot better for your image and for, you know, connecting with the right collectors. And he was like, no, I don't want to go to a niche fair because I don't want to be locked down as the street art gallery. I want to be the contemporary art gallery. Therefore, I'm in an emerging contemporary art fair. I think his point was definitely valid and it was his choice and his freedom to make such choice. Personally speaking, I would rather go to 2 different niche fairs than one a generic contemporary art fair so I can show 2 different artists in 2 different fairs and I will not be pinned down as the niche gallery because I have this 2 presence in 2 fairs with 2 different selections of works, and I can be known for the street art gallery in the street art fair and the new media art gallery for the new media art fair, and I think that's fair enough. And I think that's the whole point of the fairs, are going to find the exact audience that is right in your niche. So going to the niche fair is definitely my suggestion, but the final decision is yours. The second question you need to ask is, are the organizations very professional? And normally, unfortunately, the only way to find out is by paying them and going there and mounting your own exhibition and doing the fair, and then you know if they are good or not. And it's very hard to know beforehand. For example, I was talking to a gallerist in JustMad Art Fair, one of the parallel event, a generic, you know, emerging art fair, and he was quite upset because he told me that when he walked into the booth for the first time at the preparation, he saw the power outlet was in another part of the booth and he had to drag all the way with the cable and it was inconvenient and quite ugly and he was quite upset. On top of that, there was a large pillar in the middle of the booth and he was like, this pillar was not on the floor plan, but in fact it was like a little dot on the floor plan, but it was not exact. So as you can see, that is a huge visual obstacle in the middle of the booth and he wasn't very happy with that, let's say, interpretation of the floor plan, and he was calling it a fraud. Personally speaking, I don't think it was a fraud, but it was not a very professionally organized because it was not disclosed and warned in advance. So for that, you need to ask technical questions beforehand. You need to ask, you know, where are the power outlets? You know, how much power do I have? Do I have the wireless internet? Do I have the firewall on the Wi-Fi and network? What are the LED lights? What are the power? What are the luminosity? And normally a professional organization is able to answer all of your questions. If they're not able to answer, then you know that maybe they are not up to the level that you expect. The third thing you need to ask yourself is the price worth it? Because going to an art fair could cost anything from $1,000 to $10,000, even $30,000, depending on which fair you go. It's not very cheap. That's why you need to work out your own math to see if the artworks that you will sell during the fair will be really worth it, if the contacts you'll be making will be beneficial in the long run. So basically, you have to work out if it is worth it. I know many gallerists would make the emotional choices thinking, you know, I would need to go because it is an opportunity that I cannot lose. I would challenge you to think twice because there are many alternatives. Instead of paying for an art fair tens of thousands of dollars, you could have launched a Facebook campaign, or you could have renovated your website. You could have done so many different things with the money instead of going to art fair. So you definitely need to work out to see if it is really good value, if it will pay back on its own. Number four, is there a selection process? I believe the good art fairs should establish a transparent selection process. Let's say what kind of galleries can apply, you know, what kind of artists and artworks they can bring, and maybe they will follow a theme or follow a special curatorial program. Depending on the fair, depending on the curator of the fair and directions of the fair. However, I think a selection process is very important because you need to know other gallerists, other people in the fair will be in your league, will be in your niche, and you don't want to be, let's say, selling fish in the fruit section of the supermarket. People will look at you like you don't belong there, and the more transparent it is, the better it is, because I think the selection can be anything. The criteria is up to the direction, but it needs to be very transparent. Number five, who are the sponsors? This is probably the most overlooked question among all of the questions that people normally don't ask who are the sponsors when they go into a fair. But I think it's super important because you want to associate your brand to the sponsors who are ethical, who are according to your values. For example, if it's a fast fashion brand and you are in an ecological artist activist movement, it will not click, right? So, or if you personally believe in certain kind of religion and a certain kind of lifestyle, and the sponsor is an alcoholic beverage brand, and you may say, you know, you're not comfortable with that. So ask the organization. Usually by the time they do an open call to the participants, usually they're already having the sponsors, so you can check out what kind of sponsors they have so that you see if it will be beneficial or damaging your brand. Number six, do the art fair have a very big social media presence? And I think this is something that more traditional classical art dealers are not thinking at all. And I asked personally to some art dealers if they are, let's say, older than me, slightly older than me, and they would not even look into the social media. But I think social media is important. If the fair is really legit, if the fair have a very good communication, then they will have a lot of social media presence. And after the fair, fair, people will be visiting, engaging, and even after that you have finished the fair, you can still have the traffic, have this kind of a social following from the fair, from, you know, their website, their Instagram account, and that can be an added bonus to your social media strategy. And you're paying basically for two things. One thing is selling at the fair, another thing is being promoted by their social media. Follow their social media to see how is their engagement, their activity, if their posts are very professional and engaging. If not, if they don't even have the same level of communication as your own, I would say don't go. Otherwise, they should be paying you to promote the fair instead of you paying them to participate in the fair. Last but not the least, check out the reviews. How are the reviews of the fair? What do people say about the fair? You can go to Facebook groups, you can go to Reddit, you can go to LinkedIn or other sites like Google Map or TripAdvisor or Yelp. You can see the reviews. Those are the user-generated content and see what people are thinking and saying about it as a collector, as an artist or gallerist, or even as a worker. You can go to Glassdoor and see if the employees are happy with the organization, and then you can see from the inside out and from the past and to the future, and you can project how the art fair will be for the next edition. Then you can see if it is worthwhile for you to visit. And I know going to art fair is a large sum of money, it's a huge commitment, so don't make your decision easily. Don't stick your finger in the air and say, you know what, I think I have a good feeling about it. Trust the things you see and trust your own research. So take a pen and piece of paper, write down all the things that you concern, and then go one step by step asking those questions. Hopefully this video have helped you find the right fair for your art business. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video.